Do you think you can take the derivative of a factorial? Now I know what you're thinking. Derivatives are only defined for continuous functions, and the factorial function is a discrete function. If you wanted to graph n factorial, it would definitely not be a continuous function and not a great candidate for derivatives. So it would be really nice if we could connect all of those points and have a nice continuous function that we could take the derivative of. This is an excuse for me to talk once again about the gamma function, which generalizes the factorial function. Typically, we define gamma of x as this improper integral, and its graph looks an awful lot like it does indeed connect all of those points created by n factorial. But maybe you're not convinced that this actually is x factorial. Gamma of x is equal to x minus 1 factorial. So if we plug in 1 to this function, we want it to be 0 factorial, which is 1. Let's check this. Plug in 1 for x, we'll get t to the 0, that's 1, so it goes away, and now we just need to solve this improper integral. Take the antiderivative of the exponential function, maybe you want to rewrite those bounds in terms of limits so we can actually compute this improper integral, and we'll see after applying the fundamental theorem of calculus that this integral does indeed equal 1, which is 0 factorial. That's a great place to start, but maybe you're not quite convinced yet. We still need this general function to be x minus 1 factorial. What happens if we try to apply integration by parts here right off the bat? Let's let u be the e part, let's let dv be the t part. So we antiderive dv, we take the derivative of u, and then apply integration by parts. Uv minus the integral of v du. Again here, this was an improper integral, so when we evaluate this, we really need to take the limit as we're going to infinity, and that first part is going to 0 because the exponential function goes so much faster than the polynomial function, it kind of takes over. And so now we have this integral left over with a 1 over x in the integrand. It's dt, so in terms of dt, the 1 over x is a constant, we can just pull it out, cancel some negatives, and actually what we have left here is the gamma function at x plus 1. So gamma of x equals 1 over x gamma of x plus 1, or another way of saying that is that x gamma of x equals gamma of x plus 1, which is exactly what you want for the factorial function. And so this basically gives us exactly what we want, and we have a nice continuous factorial function. Now this is great for a lot of things, including taking factorials of non-integer values, but we can actually answer our original question, which was, how do we take the derivative of a factorial? Let's just take the derivative of the gamma function. Just to make it come out a little bit nicer, let's do gamma of x plus 1 rather than gamma of x, because we know gamma of x plus 1 is x factorial, and so this will be our computation for d dx of x factorial. So we have to take the derivative of this improper integral, and notice that the differential inside the integrand is dt. Thus, the dx we can just slip inside, and we should really be using partial derivative symbols here since we're dealing with two different variables. So let's take the partial derivative of this with respect to x. All we have to do is differentiate t to the x. Here again, it's base t, the variable is x, so the derivative of t to the x, that's t to the x, natural log t. And hey, there we go, we have the derivative of the factorial function for any x value you'd like in terms of this improper integral. Was it what you were expecting? Was it easier? Was it harder? I want to know in the comments below. And if you want to see another nice application of the gamma function with the hardest integral I've ever done, click the video on the screen right here. I'll see you in that one.